I know you've seen them, maybe on Google Hangouts, maybe on YouTube, those incredibly long video interviews with important people in your tribe. Good information, and they start well.
There are lots of important things to think about when you think about the introduction to your video.
But after 45 minutes, your subject isn't quite so fresh anymore.
I don't know. I don't remember. Introduction to what?
Not to mention what's happened to your viewer. Ooh, nasty. Let's fix this problem right now. Hi, I'm Stephen Washer, author of The Video Brain and creator of Audience Builder's Blueprint. The long video interview is a real problem in our short attention span age, but what's done is done. Chances are you were both using a webcam and the video is already on YouTube, which means it can't be shortened into a more, you know, dramatic and punchy version. Or can it? Let's take Google Hangouts, for example. Hangouts are becoming a more and more useful tool because you can get a few people on the line and switch from one to the other, or even your desktop. Plus, you can insert cool lower third graphics so the whole thing looks kind of professional. Then the whole video is hosted on your YouTube channel. Sweet. But this is all for naught if the video is still way too long. So what do you do? Well, I'll tell you what your competitors do. They do nothing at all. That's why you're going to do something better. Something to make your videos pop, not just be all right. So what do we do? Well, now you could use YouTube's editor and cut off the beginning and end. But what if you have something in the middle that really should come out?
Ooh! Yeah, that's hot! Oh!
Or what if it seems like the answers would be better if they were arranged in a different order? Well, that is what usually happens, so let's take care of that. And it's really simple to do. First, just download the video from YouTube. Just go to your control panel, twirl down the button next to your video title, and hit download. The good news is that YouTube gives you the video in its best format, so you have something decent to edit with. Now drop the video into your editing program. I'm using ScreenFlow. Cut out the parts that you don't like by using the split command. At each end of the offending part, then delete the part you don't like and push the remaining pieces back together again. If this ends up in a jump cut, you know, where it looks like the person instantly changed position on the screen, don't worry. This is one of the advantages of using Google Hangouts. The video quality is not all that good, so it really doesn't matter if you've used a jump cut or three. In fact, your audience will barely notice. Now, here's a big tip. If you really want your video to move people emotionally, lay in a music track. It can't hurt, and it gives it a nice feel, especially if it's a Google Hangout video where you don't have that much control over the look. Music will give it a professional feel, even though the image doesn't necessarily look that great. And when things sound great, they look better. I have a video all about that here somewhere. Anyway, just drop your music on a track underneath your main video, adjust the volume so it doesn't compete too much, add a fade out at the end, and voila! Your plain Jane Google Hangout video becomes a modern classic. So, if you'd like to see this action in the real world, where you can see a ton of people putting their reputations on the line, where you can see 6 hours of Google Hangout video edited down to 6 minutes, and inside those 6 minutes, see all kinds of really interesting real-world video marketing application techniques, then just click on the link below. See, you can do this stuff. Oh, and please let me know what you think about that video from the link below. I'm Steve Washer with BrainyVideo.com.